Where do I start to NPR questions to guide questions and answers to guide self-published authors? So if anyone's interested in purchasing a copy, it's with me today, and try to come out to one of my workshops. And check out my website at eclecticpr.com, because I have a lot of things for self-published authors.
Mm-hmm. Our Black Writers Guild baby in the back there.
Hi, I'm Odessa Rose, and I'm a great member of the Black Writers Guild. Been here since I first published my first book, and I just love this group. And I'm so proud of these young people here today.
Yeah. Odessa wasn't much older than you guys when she published her first book, Water in a Broken Glass.
And,
Wow. And I look at her, and it's almost a tearful thing because I've seen her develop as part of the Black Writers Guild. I'd like to think that we, the Black Writers Guild, had an integral part in her development.
You don't have to think, you did. Not at all.
And the young lady next to you, will you please stand and introduce yourself? The dancing amputee.
My name is Adrian Walker Pittman, and I'm a longtime member of the Writers Guild, and it's a great support system, a lot of friends, and folks with great knowledge about writing books. And I have a long story, and I tell it every time, but I'm not going to tell it this time. Unless I'm forced to.
No, never mind. She was in a serious car accident. She lost one of her legs, but it has not slowed her down. She dances, and she writes. Okay, Rosa.
Hi.
Rosa Griffin, I'm the secretary of Black Writers Guild. I've been a member since 2007. Mm. I've probably been a secretary too long, so if anybody else wants to be a secretary, hey, I ain't gonna fight you over that. But this has been such an inspirational group, and they inspired me to publish a book of short stories back in 2012. I waited from 2007 to 2012 to get myself together, and I published a book. So now I'm working on a short story that I'm gonna enter in a contest with the Writer's Digest.
All right. One of our board members, Maxine. Rose is going to introduce Maxine. This is Wilma Brockington Parker. Would you like to have a word?
My name is Wilma Brockington Parker. I'm your communications officer for the Guild. I've been here since 2007. I've published 3 books, and this month I'm a playwright. So if I keep saying that, about the Guild, send your emails. We do have a phone number. We are a volunteer organization. If you do call, it may take 24 to 48 hours for us to get back to you, but know that we will get back to you. We can also do email as well. And we keep you up to date via our website.
Okay. I am James Wright. I am the president of the Black Writers Guild. I published 3 books, and I'm working on my 4th with the help of Miss Wilma Brockington Parker, a big assist, and we should have something hopefully by okay.
By tomorrow?
No, not doing that. Anyway, it has been my honor and privilege to be president of this guild. And like, I wasn't joking, Kev.
I know.
I'm waiting on you. Anytime. We have to vet you, though. Remember, now I'm going to turn the program over. Oh, my goodness. Now, you know, we have some of our own resident superstars. But this young lady started as a Baltimore City delegate, and now she is a Baltimore City senator.
Awesome.
And she started in the basement of her home and became a millionaire.
Wow.
Only
God.
Only. And we met many years ago. She had one of her businesses across the street from where I live. And when I inquired as to who it was, lo and behold, it was one of my Black Writers Guild members. And she and I have had a bond since then. She's responsible for us getting better locations at the book festivals. When doors need to be forced open, she's done that. We presented before the legislature down in Annapolis to the Black Caucus. Wow. I've said enough. If you'd like to say a few words, Madam Senator.
No, you never asked a politician. Well, I'm not a politician. I'm an elected official. There's a difference.
I just want to see how much I love you.
I love you too. It's been mutual.
You know, there's no way that I could not have come. And if you know anything about it, Annapolis, this is the busiest time because we only have about 7 days left into session. And we have double meetings, and not only double meetings, but the community that I'm on, and then being a Black woman, you just can't go in there and sit. You know, you gotta get appointed to this and appointed to that, and then you sit back and you say, my plate is so full, but if your plate's not full, you have problems. That's just the way we roll. But I'm just leaving Coppin, where there was another place up there that I had to be, and I said, look, y'all gonna have to bring me on the program early, because I got to go and see my young folks. And I started writing when I was in the seventh grade, and I used to write to heal, and nobody wanted to read it until they started putting it in the school paper. I just started doing a column, and I started writing for myself, and then writing and writing. And I've written 10 books, and 6 have been published. And young people, I'm just so proud. I'm so proud of you. I went to Kipper School and spoke to the young people there on a Saturday. First, I was so impressed that it was a Saturday. And so many young people were there. So when the newspaper talk about our folks, you know, they're always coming in on stuff where it's negative, but they don't come out and see our young people filling up the classroom on a Saturday afternoon. Mm-hmm. Or come in and see our young writers. Mm-hmm. You know, I have a real issue about that. And when I visited the school and I had them to, I said, how many want to be writers? And they sent me little cards with one of my books, book number 6, I think, 5. It contains 54 original poems and 2,000 motivational quotes. So I asked them to send me samples of their writing. And I made a collage about as large as this with the cards of these young people. And the bright minds, you know, when they write things. So I just, how many of you are parents of these young people here? Keep on encouraging them. You know, keep on encouraging them. And you know what? If nobody would publish it yourself. Mm-hmm. When I first started, I had a publisher. And then when he would send me royalty checks and he was talking about, aren't you glad or congratulations? I looked at the little bit of money I had, So I created a publishing company under one of my other companies and started publishing my own work. That way I can control it, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So even if you have to do your own, keep encouraging these young people, and I just love you so much. And if there's any time that you need me, and when I brought it there at that time, I used to be chair of the Legislative Black Caucus of Maryland. I'm chair emeritus. Cheryl Glenn took over after me. But I'm still involved in a whole lot of stuff in Baltimore. So if I can help any of these bright minds, let me know. And the Writers Guild will always be my love. Always. Because you're helping young folks like this, you know, to come along. Nobody can tell our stories better than we.
No.
You know, and keep encouraging them. And you're getting the best examples or the best training or the best followers right here in the Guild. So stay connected with the Guild. You have the best people. I mean, those of us, we've been through, I mean, you know, some of us been here even just be a mama down on this earth. I know. So keep doing what you're doing and keep reaching out to people on the Guild and asking them questions. And don't think that when you ask questions that, you know, maybe they're going to think I'm dumb. The only dumb question is one that's never asked.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. And if you have to keep asking that same question over and over again 100 times until you understand, do that. You know, don't think that you, well, I don't want to worry him. I don't worry him. Worry them. Mm-hmm. They want you to worry them. We want you to worry us. Because when you worry us, then that means that one day somebody else will be worrying you. You standing on our shoulders, we had to worry somebody. So I'm just so glad that you are here and keep on doing what you're doing because it's a good thing. It's a good thing.
Thank you. I was headed away until I saw another one of our resident superstars come in. Now, before you stand, can you limit it? Because we know that words are your forte.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
My name is Terrence Cooper, and he's right to limit me, because I tell everyone, if you ask Terrence for a match, he'll give you the history of fire. I have a tendency to be long-winded. But and then I lost touch with the group for a while. I went over to Central Avenue one time. I think we were meeting there, and then because I went to the Baltimore Book Festival, so we were meeting there. Tried to track you down. But I'm glad to be with you. I'm a writer, a playwright. I've had plays produced in Chicago and in Washington D.C. And I have earned my living for more time than I will tell you, only by putting words on paper or typing them into a computer screen. And I think what Ms. Robinson said is so true. Our stories must be told, and they are beautiful, and if you ever take a look at our history, you will amaze yourself. So I came here, and once again, I'm going to make the offer at some point in time, I'm going to do a workshop for the group. And I promise you, it will be the best writing workshop you have ever had.
And that's, I can co-sign that.
I had the privilege of doing this in Washington, D.C., and Walter Dean Myers. I don't know if you know who he is. He's an author of young adult books and was at the Library of Congress for a while. He came in and he said to me, if you ever do this again, charge three times as much. Well, I won't charge three times as much because the point is to get this information to you and to help you hone your skills. It's an art and a craft, and it's something that must be mastered. So with that, I'm going to sit down.
Thank you, sir.
Because I will talk.
Now, this young lady has her laptop on her lap, but she hasn't been introduced. So can you, I mean, if you want to do it from your seat, just as long as you project, it'll be okay.
Peace and blessings, everybody. My name is Lynn Pender. I was a member, but I think I'm expired, but I will get the membership, not today, but before the year is out. I love the Black Writers Guild. It's been a great source of support for me and my endeavors. I do Tubman City News, which is an online newspaper here in Baltimore that report the news from a Christian perspective. And I also work with a great group of Christian authors. Many of them are in this room through a group called Christian Authors on Twitter.
All right, I'm done.
Rosa?
Well, I said one thing. You know, I'm taking pictures with these young people. This young lady had the card. She says, here's my business card. We are in business. We have a gourmet company. So call me and I'll give you a deal. This is not our future, this is our present.
All right. All
right. You want to introduce yourself as you come in? You're coming in. Introduce yourself.
I'm Pat Hensley, and that's my great niece right there, Kirsten Jordan.
All right.
I just want to say one other thing. For future reference, guys, for future reference, we started 1 o'clock. I thought I needed to throw that in there.
Okay.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to the Black Writers Guild Youth Showcase. I am so glad to see so many people represented for the day. Proud parents, proud grandparents, aunts, cousins, sisters, brothers. I am so glad and I welcome you. I'm not the speaker. But I want to say a few words about Maxine Bigby Cunningham, who is our moderator today. She will be asking the children the questions and handling it from there. But I want to read what she has on here. Maxine Bigby Cunningham is the founder, chief executive officer of Empowered Walking Enterprise, LLC, which offers solutions for mental and emotional wellness. For more than 30 years, she was an executive in the U.S. government and manager at nonprofit organizations. In 2011, Power Walking, A Journey to Wholeness, her book, was nominated in two categories for Dan Pointer's Global eBook Awards. Cunningham's writings have appeared in anthologies and personal growth publications. She resides in Maryland. And I have put my two cents in. Maxine Cunningham was a board member for us for a long time. She was there when nobody else was there.
That's right.
She was supporting us, and every time we had an event, she was there. And her book is very spiritual. You need to get a copy of it. She talked about the hard times she had and how she got out of those hard times. So for those of you, if anybody's out there having hard times, you need to read her book. And also Adrian's book when she gets it finished. I had to put that in Adrian. But without further ado, I'd like to introduce you to Maxine Bigby Cunningham.
Theme music.
Good afternoon. And thank you for that wonderful introduction, Rosa. I am pleased and honored to be part of this celebration, our Youth Showcase. We are here today to encourage, to recognize, support, celebrate, and showcase young writers, all of whom I believe this year
are from the city of Baltimore.
Yay.
We had an amazing panel this year. This is our third year. We have among our panelists returning, growing writers. Our panel represents very well-rounded, multifaceted, many interests young people. As Senator Robinson just pointed out, we have writers who are also entrepreneurs, like me. So I commend you. Now, writing is a discipline. It is a skill and creative art. It is a tool for communication. For some, it is a hobby. For others, it is a professional pursuit. And for all writers, it is something that is enjoyable. I'm going to ask each of our panelists a few questions, then open it up to the audience, and then I will close with a final question for our young people. Starting I'm going to introduce you all as a group. Our panelists include Aaron Bowman, who is 15 years old, homeschooled. She enjoys playing lacrosse, swimming, singing, acting, and dancing. So, in addition to being a writer, she's an athlete, and she is an entrepreneur and a performing artist in singing and acting. She has a business which, as the Senator pointed out, is a gourmet cupcake business. It is called Sister Sweets. And it is a business that she shares with her sister, Lena. She's currently working on a nonprofit organization. She writes for different topics. Currently, she's working on her first book. Lena Bowman is a 14-year-old singer, actress, baker, entrepreneur, and a writer. Save the best for last. She is homeschooled and is in the ninth grade. She's also an athlete, an entrepreneur, and she loves jazz. Lena is working to defy the myth that healthy foods cannot be tasty. She also is working on a collaborative book writing project, which she intends to complete this summer, summer 2017. Kirsten Jordan. Turn so the audience can see you. I love you. She is a high-spirited 10-year-old hailing from Baltimore, Maryland. Active in the Girl Scouts of Central Maryland, and she loves to participate in activities with her junior troop sisters. Kirsten has a heart of gold, a gift of gab, and a larger-than-life personality that is always on display. He already can testify to that. Her imagination takes flight as she weaves together storylines and alternate universes with characters that come to life through her drawings and short stories. Marco Tyrone Pearson is a 12-year-old seventh grader who attends the renowned Baltimore School for the Arts. So that is evidence of discipline as well as a joy. He enjoys writing poetry and short stories and is an avid fan of Dr. Seuss books. In addition to his thirst for writing, Marco enjoys photography, public speaking, studying Black history, and athletics.
He plays football, he knows as a center. He plays basketball, he knows as a power forward. He loves to travel, especially to the Caribbean islands. That includes many of us, I'm sure. He's looking forward to visiting Africa in the near future. One of his pastimes is making people laugh and smile. He hopes to become a comedian. Ayana Richardson is returning this year. She is a precocious 10-year-old from West Baltimore. She also has diverse interests and can be found drawing, writing, different types of books, fiction and comic books, and she enjoys playing with her keyboard. She's a fifth grader at the Loose and Branches Public School and has been a young and is a young activist who fought to keep her charter school renewed, so she's an advocate. She enjoys fiction and graphic novels. Writers read. And so, this is an example of that premise. Ethan Taylor returns to us for the third year. And it's wonderful as members of the Black Writers Guild to watch him and hopefully participate in his growth as a writer and a young man. He is 10 years old. He is a published author. He loves to have fun. Ethan's first book is entitled The Incredible Ethan Taylor. It is a published book. In addition to his fun-loving personality, Ethan loves to help others. He feeds the homeless once a month, and when given an opportunity, he speaks to youth groups. Ethan motivates other children to pursue their dreams just like him. He's working on bringing his books to shelters and reading them to children who are homeless. His books are very adventurous, and so adventurous that any reader just might forget some of them are fictional. Ethan now has 5 books published, 2 books waiting to be released. Well, I guess I have to hurry up and catch up with you. Ethan plans to continue his writing career into adulthood. This is your panel members. Write in what genre?
I'm sorry.
Fiction, autobiographical, stories about yourself, which I understand the first one, nonfiction, poetry.
I write fiction books. The next few books is going to be kind of nonfiction, but fiction as well. But I'm the type of person who writes books as fiction. I like books that's really dark, that's fun. That's fun for my kids.
Sounds like you have a great imagination. And how long have you been writing? You're now 10?
I've been writing since 7.
Since age 7. Almost a veteran. As well. Ayana, What type of writing are you pursuing that you now have?
Well, I only write nonfiction. I mean, not nonfiction. Fiction writing. Mm-hmm. But every now and then, I try my hand in poetry, which I find myself good at, but nobody really cares to read it.
Say that again.
Nobody really cares to read it.
Poetry?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Maybe you can share some of your poetry sometime and we'll see if that is universal or true.
Well, I like to write comedy. I like to see people laugh and have a nice time. Because I believe if you laugh, you're enjoying yourself and you're happy. And I also like to write alternate history, what if this didn't happen? Will you still be in the same place as where I'm here?
Okay. And how long have you been writing?
I've been writing since I was 10. And I was writing on a book called, it was about, what if the Native Americans won the war?
Mm.
Wow.
Done that is heavy.
Yeah, right. You really? Wow.
Okay.
Wow.
I like to write fictional horror stories. I find myself very good at those because I prefer to write horror stories for some reason. I don't know why. But yeah, I guess one reason why I like to write horror stories is because. It's because they're interesting to me and they're full of lots of mysteries and lots of horror, I guess. And the weird thing is that I can read an entire book of horror stories. Yeah, I can't watch a horror movie.
What happens when you try to watch horror movies?
I believe.
Nope.
Scary, they can be scary.
Yes, but yeah, I do love to write horror stories. I've tried happy stories before. I'm not that good at them because I'll end up writing a little horror in it without me realizing. So yeah, and I think I've been writing for pretty much a long time, pretty much since I was 5. I just haven't realized it because at my school KIPP, sometimes we get to write our own little fictional stories or non-fictional stories, little essays, and I enjoy those a lot, especially when I get to type them up on the computer.
Okay, thank you. KIPP, that's one of Senator Robinson's precious schools, right?
Oh, yeah, KIPP. So, no wonder she has this great personality.
Knowledge is power program. KIPP, KIPP.
Okay. Lena.
Well, I like to write both nonfiction and fiction books, but sometimes I like to write songs. I used to really write a lot of songs when I was younger, but I haven't really done it that much recently, but I like to write both the fiction and nonfiction stories.
And how long have you been writing,
Nina?
Or writing?
It was 10 or 9 or 10.
Thank you.
She was younger.
And Aaron.
I've been writing for about maybe 5 years. When I was younger, my sister and I used to write songs together, but I used to always try to make them rhyme, but then it didn't make sense, so I kind of gave up on that. And I recently, 2 years ago, I started writing nonfiction books. I started writing 2 years ago. And what's the other question?
The type of writing and how long you've been writing, so you can answer both questions.
Yes.
Thank you. I want to thank Senator Robinson for doing the lead-in to this next question. And I will be starting with Aaron. The question is, why do you write? Senator Robinson said she writes to heal. There are many reasons for writing. Why do you write?